On this video, which is the last one, the third of the three-part series to bring your photos live in Final Cut Pro 10, we're gonna see how we can take a picture with a road and transform it into a mountain, into a scenery, 3D scenery in Final Cut Pro 10 using the FCPX Photo Depth plugin. Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are watching me for your first time, I'm Emilio Takas and I post videos here on tutorials, filmmaking tips, gear reviews and much more. So if you're into this kind of stuff, consider subscribing to my channel and also don't forget to ring the notification bell to receive notifications every time I post a new video. So as I said in the beginning of this video, we're gonna see the FCPX Photo Depth plugin in action. We can see how we can create an image with a road and some mountains to be shown like the video that you saw in the beginning. And for those of you who are interested to get this plugin from Pixel Film Studios, you can use the link in the description of this video down below and the coupon code EMILIOPIXEL to get 30% off your purchase. Let's go now into Final Cut Pro 10 and see the plugin in action. We are in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface and I have placed the photo that we will work on today to showcase the FCPX Photo Depth plugin from Pixel Film Studios. Now the first thing that we want to do is to go into Titles, drag the Height Map tool for this example, bringing on top of the image, and I'm gonna adjust the length to be the same as the photo on the bottom. On this example, around 5 seconds. For the next step, we select the adjustment layer of the Photo Depth plugin and we go into the Spectro panel. We can click on the instructions if we want to see the instructions and you don't want to hear what I have to say on this video, but let's see it. As you can see from the brush mode here, we are going to start, and as I'm making the strokes here, you see that it's it doesn't have any feathering, it's very full. And what I want to do is, first of all, to increase a little bit the feathering. As you can see, now it's better. From here, I can adjust the stroke size, okay? And now remember here that, let me just show you here, you see that? Okay, now remember that if I click on the mask layer guide, I'm gonna see the color in red, okay? The more red, that means that it's gonna be more near into the video. The less red means that it's gonna be further in our screen, so it won't have so much height. Now, if I deselect the mask layer guide, you can see same thing for the white, more near, less white, further away. We will select the resolution. For this example is 1080, so if you're working with different resolutions, you select the resolution, okay? If I click here on clear all strokes, I can start from the beginning, and also, as you can see here, with fill stroke selected, I can have this, and it will fill all the area that I'm gonna draw the stroke, okay? So let's say if I do this, boom. I have all the area, right? So let's do something first for all the area around the road. Okay, I can change the size here. Okay, and I'm going now. I will adjust the opacity, the brightness, the feathering, all of these options as I'm going into the map, okay? So, as you see here, just make this stroke a little bit bigger. So, as I'm increasing the opacity and the brightness, okay, you see that I'm selecting areas where I want the mountains to appear bigger, okay? So, as I said, the more white is more close. If I click here, the mask layer guide, yep, that's easier. Here, I can select the mountain. And if I don't want to be automated, okay, I deselect the fill stroke, so I can have the areas that I want to be more near, okay? Let's leave this field here, okay? Now I can change the stroke opacity as well, increase a little bit the feather, so I can go next to the road. Okay, so we can select everything. Now, wait a moment, because what you're gonna see, how this is gonna look, it's gonna be something that it's gonna amaze you, like the video you saw in the beginning. These are examples of plugins that we never had the slightest idea that we're gonna have in Final Cut. So, if I make the brightness now of the stroke, you see, I turn that to the left, and let me decrease a little bit the feathering and the opacity, okay. Now, if I select here, let's decrease the size, I'm gonna go with the road and select the road. Because I don't want to be the road, I don't want to be in a 3D dimension, I don't want a height on it, okay? So I'm gonna make it as flat as possible. Now, don't worry that you have to be 100% precise with the drawings, and I'm gonna show you why. If we select here, we can adjust, and let's zoom in. We can adjust the path, okay? So if we click here, we can correct any direction that we made by mistake, okay, when we were running the line. So this is gonna be easier for us to correct anything that, you know, might went wrong in the process of drawing the road with our hands. Okay, let's have it fitted. Okay, and correct a little bit as well. Here and here. Wonderful. And also we can adjust and change any of the strokes that we have. Now, as soon as we finish with that, let me deselect the mask layer guide. I will go here and I will select the camera mode. And now the magic happens. So, as you can see here, I can change the maximum height. You see already that it's becoming to look more like a mountain, okay? I can make it to bend to left or bend to right. And what is more important is that if you see right here, we have keyframes. So I can change all of these parameters on the inspector panel as I'm moving forward from here to here. So for the animation of the element that I have. Now, on the camera controls here, we can either change them by the inspector panel, or we can change them from here. For example, if I select here, we see that I'm changing the rotation of the X and Y axis, okay? So if I bring it here, we see the mountains. And we might say, wait a minute, this is not very realistic. So let me decrease a little bit of the height. And then bring it a little bit here as well. We can make it a photo to look exactly like it was a video, right? Closest to a video. With this, we can zoom in, okay? As you can see. And with that, we can control the position, like top or left, or bottom or right. So let's zoom a little bit as well here. Okay. Let's bring this down a little bit. Also, if I click on the instructions, go here, you will see that with the tool of the pan, of the rotate and of the zoom, with the pan, if I drag up or down, I can move the camera vertically, left or right, move the camera horizontally, and if I hold shift and drag, the movement is gonna lock to a single axis. Now, on the rotate, if I hold command and drag up or down, I will rotate vertically only, with the option horizontally, and with the shift, I'm gonna spin the camera. What do I mean by spin the camera? I'm holding the shift now, you see? some spinning the camera from left to right. So you can play with all of that. Now you can adjust, let's adjust a little bit the zoom as well. Okay, if I change the angle of view, you see here, and let me decrease a little bit of the maximum height. Okay, and if I add now keyframes, not in the maximum height, but let's add a keyframe to the position. Okay, the rotation, the anchor point, and the zoom. And go to the end of the layer, okay, here, and make any changes to that. For example, I want this to be even more zoomed, and I want this to be more at the top, and change this as well. Zoom in a little bit. The final result is going to look like this. I'm making any movement I want. Also, I can change the angle of view, okay, as we saw before. I can change the depth of field, so I can make it look, as you can see here, I can make it look with depth of field, with a blur. I can change the focus, the near focus, the far focus. I can select to infinity focus. There are so many different variations on the details that you see on the right on the spectral panel that you can play with your image and use your creativity to transform this static image into the video that you saw in the beginning. I hope you found this video helpful and you learned something new today. And if you did, please do all these amazing YouTube stuff. Like this video, subscribe, and ring the notification bell to receive notifications every time I post a new video. And if you just want to say hi, I'm waiting you in the comment section down below. Huge shout out to Pixel Film Studios for supporting this channel, and also keep in mind that they started some new Final Cut Pro 10 tutorials, so you can go there and check them out. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio Takas, and I will see you in the next video.